In year two of COVID, there was one headline that had employees intrigued and employers worried.
What's been dubbed the Great Resignation.
It's the Great Resignation.
The Great Resignation.
Great Resignation is the word for it.
And now there's more evidence that workers are all like... ABS figures show industrial disputes are at their highest level since 2018, with workers pushing for better pay and conditions at a time when companies can't afford to lose strong employees.
What we've seen coming out of COVID is a huge growth in employment. We've also seen, obviously, the lack of migration, skilled migration in particular. And that means the pendulum really has swung to employees.
This year, widespread strikes at the height of our lockdown online delivery spree resulted in wage increases for FedEx, Toll and StarTrak employees.
We learned today that there are right ways and wrong ways of getting what you want.
A similar power shift is also being seen in the US, where unemployment is currently at a 52-year low. Almost 4.5 million employees quit their jobs in September alone. According to the 2021 Work Trend Index, around 40% of the global workforce at least considered quitting their jobs this year.
So actually, moving jobs is a really good way to get a pay rise. And we find this in the data even before this current situation. But talk to your employer because they may be willing to match whatever you can get.
But not all workers are likely to cash in on this change in the wind.
Not only do women not tend to ask as much for pay rises, they're less successful when they do. We have certainly seen in the last 12 months, for example, where male weekly earnings have gone up 3 times the rate of female earnings during this period.
So is now the time to shop around for a better job or at least get a pay bump for the one you've already got?
Any job worth doing is worth doing well, no matter how dull it may seem at the time. Bye for now.
Well, Dr. Richard Dennis is the Chief Economist at the Australia Institute and he joins us now. So, Doc, how long is the workplace situation going to be like this and do workers need to jump on this opportunity right now?
Look, no one's quite sure what's going to happen, but it is a once-in-a-generational opportunity. There's we've got record low unemployment. There's a lot of employers out there looking for staff, and it's a great time for people to be looking for new jobs, looking to move into new industries and to ask for pay rises.
Is it a bad sign that it took a pandemic and global supply chain disruption for workers to get a better deal?
Look, absolutely. I mean, the head of the RBA has been saying for years that what Australia needs is some wages growth, and everyone's agreed that we should have wages growth, but none of the employers have really agreed that they should be the ones offering the wages growth. But what we're seeing now is a lot of employers struggling to find the staff they want with the skills they need, and the simple solution there is to offer better pay. And to be clear, that's what the Reserve Bank's been saying for quite some time, is that's what Australia needs.
So how does this work if you're watching this tonight? Do you walk into your job, no matter what you do tomorrow, and say, hey, boss, I want a pay rise?
Look, it's awkward. A lot of people find that very hard. But yes, effectively, that's what has to happen. Or you might do it with some of your colleagues in tow. You might do it through your union. But really asking for a pay rise has become a very unfamiliar thing. I've spoken to a lot of young people and asked them, when was the last time you asked for a pay rise? And the most common answer is, I never have. So it's a bit awkward. But if you don't do it, you're probably not going to get one.
So how do you do it then, Richard? When do you ask your boss for a raise and how? For example, maybe right after this show has finished filming?
Well, not by text and not when your boss seems busy. Look, you're spot on. A lot of people have never done it, and that speaks volumes about the Australian labour market. But look, it's an interpersonal skill. You've got to get the timing right, but you can't be shy about it. It's like asking someone out on a date. At some point, you just have to do it.
You've got to delete that text you were drafting, Tom.
I was going to message my employer on TikTok. That was going to be my plan.
Good luck with that.
Maybe there's an emoji for it.
please. Thanks so much for that, Richard.
Thank you.
I've come up with another idea of how to get a raise. Demand one on live television. I demand a raise.
I know you're new here. You've actually got to ask Lisa.
Okay, Lisa, I demand a raise. I'm being told I'm definitely not getting a raise.
I'll see you afterwards.
Yeah. It's interesting though, isn't it, in saying how women don't have the courage to ask. I don't think I've ever asked for a raise. And I also know that I've been in jobs where the men around me have been getting pay rises as well.
So why haven't you asked?
I just think that I probably haven't had the confidence to do it. More so now, absolutely, I would, but I think back on my previous jobs, knowing the men have been getting a lot more than I have and have also at negotiation time been getting more.
There's an incredible Australian woman who used to work here at Channel 10. Actually, she developed an app in America called Pep Talker. Her name's
Brilliant.
Megan Palmer.
Yes. She's incredible.
And it is designed precisely to help in this situation.
It gives me goosebumps. I follow her and just her wording, every woman should absolutely follow it because the tips she gives are absolutely brilliant. Pep Talker is the name of the
You just got the pay rise from them that you're asking for.
Yeah.